Hello friends, welcome to Global Online University. Friends, I am Bahubali. In this video, we are going to discuss some important MCQs on research aptitude. And for your upcoming AP SET examination, we are providing you full syllabus with video lecture crash course. Okay, only at ₹1999. Here you will get full syllabus video lectures plus 20 mock tests with PDF solution. Only at ₹1999 on our Global Online University app. The link for app will be given in the description box. And alternatively, you can join only for 20 mock tests, which are available only at ₹499 with PDF solution. And these mock tests are available on our website and also on our paid WhatsApp group. And once if you pay the fee, send the screenshot to this number and you will be added to our paid WhatsApp group. Here we will get 20 mock tests, PDF of links, and you can download the PDF. You can clarify your doubts and all. And you, for any queries, you can contact to this given number. And this is our schedule of 20 mock tests. And if you have any confusion related to our mock test series, you can first test is free. You can come and check your score. Let us move to the questions. Here the question is, the difference between the sample value expected and the estimates value of the parameter is called as option A, bias, option B, error, option C, contradiction, option D, difference. Here the questions are also there in Telugu. You can pause the video and you can read the questions in Telugu. Okay, friends, when there is a difference between sample and population, okay, it is referred as population means whole population. Sample means we are taking only some representative from the sample. Here the difference between sample value expected and the estimates value of the parameter is called as option A, bias is the right answer. Please remember, it is known as the bias. And when there is a difference between expected sample value and the estimated parameter, it is called bias. Okay, please remember it. And a sample used to estimate a parameter is unbiased if the mean of its sampling distribution is exactly equal to the true value of the parameter. Okay, just remember, the difference between expected sample value and the parameter value, it is known as the bias. Let us move to the next question. In which of the following types of sampling the information is carried out under the opinion of an expert? Option A, quota sampling. Option B, convenient sampling. Option C, purposive sampling. Option D, judgment sampling. Here the right answer is option D, judgment sampling is the correct answer, because we are using the judgment given by the expert. And what do we mean by judgment sampling? It is carried out under an opinion of an expert. Please remember it. And the judgment sampling often results in a bias because of the variance in expert opinion. Please remember this line. Okay, it leads to bias because of the variance in the expert opinion. Let us move to the next question. Selection of a football team for FIFA World Cup is called as option A, random sampling. Option B, systematic sampling. Option C, purposive sampling. Option D, cluster sampling. Here the right answer is option C, purposive sampling is the right answer. Okay, the next question is, a researcher divides the population into PG graduates and 10 plus 2 students, and using the random digit table, he selects some of them from each. This is technically called option A, stratified sampling. Option B, stratified random sampling. Option C, representative sampling. Option D, none of these. Here the right answer is, it is known as the stratified random sampling, because here researcher is going to divide the population, okay, into PG graduates and 10 plus 2, and he is selecting the population by using random sampling. Then it is called stratified random sampling. Okay, here you can see the explanation. Division of a population on the basis of class, income, education level, etc. is called stratification. Okay, and every member of each stratum has equal chance of being selected in the sample. In this way, it is known as the stratified random sampling. So let us move to the next question. A researcher divides his population into certain groups and fixes the size of the sample from each group. It is called option A, stratified sample, option B, quota sample, option C, cluster sample, option D, all of the above. I hope you got the answer, because we have discussed in the previous slide only slide about the stratified random sampling. It is little bit different. Here a researcher divides his population into certain groups and he is going to select some groups by randomly. So it is known as the quota sampling. Quota means group. Okay, and let us move to the next question. Area sampling or cluster sampling technique is used when option A, population is scattered and large size of the sample is to be drawn, option B, population is heterogeneous, option C, long survey is needed, option D, if both A and C. Here both A and C. Okay, friends, here the right answer is option D, both A and C. Area sampling or cluster sampling is used when population is scattered and large size of the sample is to be drawn, and when long survey is needed. So both A and C are correct here. And when long survey is being done, population is being scattered over a large area, then researcher uses area sampling or cluster sampling. So let us move to the next question. Logic of induction is very close to option A, the logic of sampling, option B, the logic of observation, option C, the logic of the control variable, option D, none of the above. Okay, here the right answer is option A, the logic of sampling. Please remember it, logic of induction is very close to the logic of sampling. Let us move to the next question. Seeing a very big rally, it was reported that JD will win the election. The conclusion was based on, please remember, seeing a very big rally, option A, random sampling, option B, cluster sampling, option C, systematic sampling, option D, purposive sampling. The right answer is option B, cluster sampling. And what do we mean by cluster sampling? Cluster sampling is a sampling plan when we use mutually for homogeneous population. If the population is homogeneous, we can use cluster sampling. Yet internally heterogeneous groupings are evident in a statistical population. It is often used in the marketing research. In cluster sampling, the total population is divided into subgroups, and by using simple random sampling, group will be selected. The next question is, a researcher can keep the sample size low if population is heterogeneous, inaccessible, homogeneous, all of the above. I hope you got the answer. If the population is homogeneous, then a researcher will keep the sample size less. Let us move to the next question. If a researcher selected 5 schools at random and then interviewed each of the teachers in those 5 schools, the researcher used simple random sampling, stratified random sampling, cluster random sampling, none of the above. I think you got the answer. Here the right answer is cluster random sampling. If a researcher select 5 schools at random and then interviewed each of the teachers in those 5 schools, the researcher is used cluster sampling, because he is dividing the schools into subgroups. Let us move to the next question. A representative sample is essential in option A, survey method, option B, experimental method, option C, case study, option D, clinical method. Here the right answer is option A, survey method. A representative sample is essential in survey method. The next question is, when a research problem is related to heterogeneous population, the most suitable method is option A, cluster sampling, option B, stratified sampling, option C, convenient sampling, option D, lottery method. Okay, when the research problem is related to heterogeneous population, then the researcher will use stratified sampling. Please remember the answer. And stratified sampling is a method of sampling from a population which can be partitioned into subpopulation. Then by using random sampling, he is going to select the groups. Okay, the next question is, an investigator wants to study the vocational aspirations of visually challenged children in a wide geographical area. He should select his sample by using option A, simple random sampling, option B, stratified sampling, option C, purposive sampling, option D, convenient sampling. Here the correct answer is option B, stratified sampling. Okay friends, this is about today's session, and for your AP set examination we are providing you full syllabus video lecture crash course plus 20 mock tests on our global online university app only at ₹1999. Alternatively, if you don't want to join for crash course, you can only join for 20 mock tests with solution PDF only at ₹499 on our website and on our WhatsApp group. These 20 mock tests are very helpful to boost your preparation. Here you will get the question options in both the languages, in English and in Telugu, and also you can download the PDF with solution. Okay, and once if you join for our crash course or mock test, you will be added to our paid WhatsApp groups where you will get the link of the test, where you can get download the solution PDF and all. To join for these mock tests or crash course, you can contact to this given number. Okay, thank you. For more videos on UGC NET and for various set examination, you can subscribe to our global